I was born in Salt Lake City and lived there all my life until I got married. I was the youngest child of four children. My mother and father met in Logan, Utah. My mother taught school and also my father. And my mother had quite a few beaus. She was a beautiful lady and wore beautiful clothes all of her life. I had an older sister. She was 14 when I was born, and she took over being my mother because my mother was ill a lot when I was a baby. Then I had a brother and then another sister. She was 10 years older than I. So as I was growing up, I felt much like an only child. I was lonely a lot. I was kind of a tag along with my parents. They took me everywhere with them. The only grandparent I knew at all well was my grandfather, Benjamin Lillywhite, and he was always a hero to me because he walked across the plains when he was only 9 years old, helping to push a hand cart, and he would tell us stories of the pioneer days. My grandmother Jones I saw when I was a little child, but she died when I was 6 years old.
Okay, unlike Mom, I was the oldest of the children in our family. I was born in northwestern Germany. I had two sisters and a younger brother, two younger sisters and a younger brother. My mother came from a well-to-do farm family, and my dad was always in some kind of business, and he was sort of a domineering head of the household. My parents were converted to the Mormon Church by missionaries in the early 20s, and as a result of that, and also because of poor economic conditions in Germany at the time, they decided to move to emigrate to the United States. And we settled first in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and then 5 years later, in 1933, we moved to Utah, to Salt Lake City, where my dad got involved in the hotel business.
I met Ernie in a rather unusual way. I fell in love with his picture before I ever saw him. We started to date and hit it off very well right from the beginning, and things were really getting interesting when he dropped the news that he was enlisting in the Navy, and it was tough being without him. I finally drove to Berkeley, California when he was stationed on Treasure Island, and we were married there in an LDS church by an LDS bishop. Then he was transferred to the other side of the country, but on the way we stopped in Salt Lake City and were married in the temple. He went on to New York. I followed him to New York and Maryland until he was finally heard from him. When he couldn't call me anymore, I knew he was shipped overseas. And it was hard being without him. I went back to Salt Lake City, and I was pregnant with Hal, and I had, Hal was born while Ernie was overseas, and Ernie didn't see him until he was 18 months old.
After the war, we wound up in Los Angeles because my dad was doing pretty well in the hotel business down there. And then Stephen was born in 48. We bought a house in Glendale. And then Margaret was born in 49. And about this time, we found out the GI Bill was still good for college, so Mom encouraged me to go back to school. I went to USC and went there for about 2.5 years and got my degree in mathematics. And because of my good grades, I got a good job at Douglas Aircraft in Santa Monica, which caused us to buy a house in Mar Vista.
I'd like to say that Ernie worked very hard to get his education. That wasn't something that his parents fostered and that came easily to him. He worked very hard and worked in the hotel. At the same time, I didn't exactly have it easy with three little children, but I was glad to do it. I loved having the children. The reason Stephen and Margaret were so close together is that I had three miscarriages after Hal, and I was so anxious to have more children, and I thought it was just the most delightful thing to be pregnant and carrying a baby in my arms at the same time and to be able to wheel two babies in a buggy. And that was a happy time when we lived in Mar Vista, even though it was hard in some ways. Don was born in our house at Mar Vista, and he was a beautiful, loving little boy. He was very good-natured when he was little, and right away he began showing signs of liking animals and pets. And I can remember the ducks waddling around in our backyard and Don trailing after them as he could hardly walk himself. We then soon moved to Wynkoop, and that was sort of our dream home. I can remember when we were looking at the house, I would drive over there to Westchester and go past that house until the neighbors began being suspicious before we even bought it. But that is the place we really feel like our family grew up there, and it was a great place to live. We really had a great family life then. I think that was the most exciting time in my life when we had all five of the little children. Well, of course, Larry was born on Wynkoop too. Westchester Ward was a wonderful place to raise our children. We had a great bishop, Bishop Bearclough, and he was like a second father to all of our children, with Don Alder and Al White helping him. I can remember when our boys left on their missions or went to school, they would come home the first thing, look inside the refrigerator, and then go see Bishop Bearclough. All of our boys left on their missions. Hal was the first one to go to Australia. That seemed like the end of the world to us. Then Stephen went to Ireland, an unlikely place for an asthmatic child to go, but it proved to be a fine place, and he had the faith and the strength to get along without any problems. Don went to Uruguay, a faraway place too, full of new experiences, and Larry left for New York State, all from Westchester Ward. Margaret had her real wedding in our backyard, and that was a treasured memory. All so many wonderful things happened in Westchester in our family. We loved the people there, where there was a large ward with lots of children. Our children were very active in all kinds of activities. I enjoyed my church work there very, very much, and it was just a wonderful place to raise our family, and it will always be home to us.
Throughout the years, one of my main activities was a membership in the Southern California Mormon Choir. I was a charter member in 1953 and stayed with it for about 38 years until I retired just recently. As a result of being a member of the choir, Mom and I got to see many different places in the world on our concert tours, like, for instance, Hawaii and Israel, in Mexico City, where we saw their new temple being constructed, and New Zealand and Australia. The choir gave me a perfect outlet for my love of music, and it was an important part of my life. The choir also served a missionary function, because we gave concerts to many non-members and opened some doors for missionaries, I'm sure. Of course, the other important part of my life was sports, and having four boys, I got involved in Little League and in junior softball in the church, in fact, our junior softball team went to the all-church tournament in Salt Lake City 3 different years until they stopped having those. We also had a bowling league in our stake, which for many years, and of course all this time I was playing tennis, and in later years I turned my attention to golf. In the last 10 years or so, we acquired a motorhome, and Mom and I took some memorable trips with our motorhome. The first big one was clear across the country, where we went through 25 states and 8,000 miles. And then another one was later into Canada, through Calgary and Banff and Jasper National Parks, Lake Louise, and then over to Vancouver for Expo 86, was it? So those were things that we'll always remember.
As much, I enjoyed raising my children so much that when Larry left and went to kindergarten, I was sort of lost, and I had to do something else. So I began playing with flower arrangements, and that proved to be a creative outlet for me, and even the boys helped me deliver them to the different places where I took them. Then after that, I became interested in teaching nursery school, because I have always had a great love for children, and I became involved with cooperative nursery school, where the mothers would help and I could give little education to the mothers along with teaching the children at the same time, and I enjoyed doing that for many years. As I get older, it's hard for me to have to give up my church activities and have to be going slower as I am now, but a great blessing is seeing my children and grandchildren also actively engaged in church work. It's a great blessing to see all of them doing so well in serving the Lord. We are proud of our grandsons going on missions, and we've enjoyed going to the blessings of new babies and the baptisms and graduations and all the joys that come to grandparents when they live this long. And now we have our own little cozy nest in Salt Lake to come to when we want, and it's easy to take care of. And now our grandchildren are coming to, and our children are coming to see us, to go swimming in the pool and visiting us here. And that's a great joy to be able to go back and forth between California and Utah and enjoy all of our children. It's been a wonderful life for us.
You know, I was 14 when we left Germany, and before then, little did I think that I would even live to the age that I am now, and that I would be enjoying a large family and two homes and nice cars, and that I would be buried in a little town of Brigham City, where our burial plot is at present. Of course, I've been active in sports all my life. I was slowed down a little bit lately by knee replacement and hip replacement, but life isn't over yet, because I'm back to playing golf, and I expect to hope to be doing it a few more years.